Now, challenges faced by social entrepreneurs, lack of a perfect business plan and lack of awareness among the general public, this is the major problem for social entrepreneurs, because people don't have any idea about their problems, and social entrepreneurs are trying very hard to bring a positive change in the society. And confusion with work, social entrepreneurship in India is being used with.
Sir,
conclusion is social entrepreneurship can change the face of the society, and for social entrepreneurship, a big slogan for them: be a solution for the nation, not a problem. It is the best combination of social service and skills to look for social problems. Thank you so much.
Ms. Deepu, we are going to present our views on agro entrepreneur. So, who is an entrepreneur? He or she is a person who looks for change, take risk, and start an enterprise. So, who is an agro entrepreneur? The entrepreneur who deals with the directly or indirectly with the agriculture products and services. Agro business type. There are four major types of agro business type. That is agriculture product business, agriculture equipment business, agriculture service business, agrochemical business. So first of all, agriculture product business. It deals with the production of agriculture products, that is plants or animals, for commercial purposes, so as to make profit. While talking about the facts and figures, it is the livelihood for around 58% of Indian population. Around 7.67 million in financial year of 2018 has been contributed by the agriculture product business. So talking about agriculture equipment business, value of sales of new farm equipment in 2018 was Euro 1.75 billion. This is around this is expected that in 2017 it would be around 2 billion higher. And for tractor market, it is expected to 8 to 10% increase in financial year 2019. Agriculture service business, 1 to 6 months metric tons capacity, and around 75% of numbers of godowns have a capacity of less than 1000 metric tons. Insurance is being provided by the government with a premiums of around 62% to the farmers. While talking about the logistics, the growth rate accuracy of Niti Aayog logistics sector provides around 22 million jobs. Next slide. Agrochemical business. While talking about the agrochemical business, 10 to 14% of export has been due to the rupee downfall. UPL, that is United Phosphorus, one of the largest agrochemical companies with a nearly 80% exposure of export. UPL has reported total sales of rupees 70,000 crore last year. So next will be presented by Ms.
So here's some startup results. Setcher founded in early 2016. Setcher has been at the front for bringing best practice to inside-track image processing. And the next is Fossil founded by Shalendra Tiwari and Anand Verma. They explained that as the startup collects more data, AI-based microclimate forecasting algorithm incorporates real and field information. And IBM is the first smart farming collective. So the startup runs around the fortune of small farm with the internal AI and shared service. And the next is Cropping. Bangalore-based Cropping provides a full site of farm management, monitoring, and analytical solution. Last year, company invested $5 million toward AI developing a new product called SmartRisk. SmartRisk is essentially a digital platform for a microfinance banking, non-banking institution to identify and minimize the risk of lending and insurance business. And the next is Lead Group. Lead Group, which is raised funding from SLR recently, is another player which works with small holders and vegetable farmers in South India. here is some problem faced in Indonesia. Poverty. Poverty is 23.6% of Indian population is under below poverty line. And technology failure. So good population but few usage of technology. It's all about the unawareness of government plans, latest technology and government policy, productivity fears and legal restrictions. Because many people are not aware about legal restrictions. And next is poor infrastructures, unaware funding of cash, less productivity, limited water supply. So government runs the RKVI, the Rashtriya Krishi Vikas Yojana. This program, the National Agriculture Development Program, is state grant scheme, additional central assistance launched in August 2007. It's an 11th five-year plan. It seeks to achieve 4% annual growth in agriculture. And NFSM is a national food security mission and central scheme approved by Government of India, launched in 2007. So it's to increase production and productivity of wheat, rice, and pulse. And NHM is a national horticulture commission. This scheme is not available in Anpani, Kumbha, Lakshadweep, and seven northeast states, Sikkim, Jammu and Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, and Uttarakhand. And ISOPOM, it's an integrated scheme of oil seeds, pulses, oil town, and dairy. The first program of oil seeds launched in 1986, but it's not added pulses, oil town, and dairy. They were added in 1990. And Gramin Bhandaran Yojana, under the Gramin Bhandaran Yojana or Rural Godown scheme, the government provides support to an individual, a company, a farmer, NGOs and various associations. If they build or renovate godown in rural areas, they provide 25% of the capital investment in. If the women farmer renovate godown, so they have 33.33% of the total capital investment.
Yes.
And so agri business
what is your finding in one line? Finding in one line.
Sir, the challenges and the scope which are the agro business entrepreneurs are facing, we are dealing with it, sir. Yes. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Now, may I request our principal, sir, to please present the memento to Shri Kamal Hansi, Chief Manager, NSIC.
Aggarwal College faculty welcome you all to the 6th technical session of National Conference Entrepreneurship Development Causes of Wealth for People and Economy sponsored by Director Higher Education Haryana. Welcome again. Now I request our chairperson Dr. Dishan Kant Gupta ji to please take the seat. Please sir. Dr. Shilpa Goyal, OS of the conference, to present a booklet. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, sir. I also request Dr. Usha Chaudhary to present a booklet, Professor S.K. Chakravarti.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am. I also request Dr. Shobhana Goyal to present the bouquet to Mr. Vivek Agarwal. Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am. Now I will.
In this session, we have two invited speakers, Professor Aggarwal and Mr. Vivek Aggarwal, and around 5 to 6 oral presentations. For those who have come to our college first time, I would like to introduce Professor S.K. Chakravarti. Professor Chakravarti retired from NIT Kurukshetra as a professor, dean, Gilman Control of Examinations also. After superannuation, Gilman will YMC University as advisor research with Manavatna International University. And presently he is a freelancer. And he is in one way or the other associated with our college also. He is an external expert in our IQAC, Internal Quality Assurance Set, and member of our academic council. He is an eminent academician, speaker, widely traveled person, more than 600 research publications in national and international journals. So many PhD students he has produced, and one of them is sitting as a chairperson of this session in front of you. We are happy to have you, sir. You will be delivering your talk today in this session. The second speaker is Vivek Aggarwal, young entrepreneur. He is also related to our college. We have an MOU, Memorandum of Understanding, with his industry. And on various occasions, he visits our college, our students visit his industry, and we keep on doing activities and collaboration. I welcome both the speakers to the session, and may I request Professor Chakravarti to be able to
start. I have been a teacher for around 50 years, so therefore I think I can touch any topic. And as a matter of fact, when Krishnakant asked me, would you sir speak on entrepreneurship, I said yes, why not, I can speak on that. Would you like to be under a boss? Perhaps at home everybody is under a boss. But in reality, would you like to be? So I say, be your own boss. It's nice to be your own boss. Obviously, why? Because you have all the powers with you. This word, entrepreneur, is from French origin and is defined as a person who organizes and manages a business undertaking, assuming the risk for the sake of profit. Sake of profit, pure business involved. Unless there is a profit, no one is entrepreneur. It's a doing social service sort of thing. No one does it. Why be an entrepreneur? What does it take to be an entrepreneur? Entrepreneurs are important to the nation's economy, of course, to us. If they don't do business of the economy of the world and the country itself is not improved upon. Of course, you have the risk, working long hours, having an uncertain income.